for the older generation, language barrier is still an issue. You see, after they came here, they might have done ESL up to level one, level five or level six, but they didn't go for any other education more than that. So language barrier still exists. Recently, I got a call from an older woman who went to see her doctor, and she would understand the day-to-day English, but he told her that she would be doing a colonoscopy. So when he told her that she would be doing the colonoscopy, she said, yes, okay. But she didn't really understand what he was talking about and what he was explaining. So the good thing though, she wrote down the term, or I don't know whether she memorized it, but she gave me a call. And she said to me, I went to see a doctor, my doctor, and he told me that this is what he is going to do, and this is where I'll be going. And she said to me, I remember the word he told me, and this is the word, colonoscopy. And she said to me, what is it? So I explained it to her. So then she said, oh, that thing, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to go for that test. I'm not going to do it. And she said, that's not something we do in our culture. You see, how would you do something like that? You know, it's against our culture. It's against our religion. And she said, I'm not going to do it. And she said, that's not acceptable. And she said, if I had understood it right there, I would have told my doctor. Well, I said to her, how is it, against your culture? How is it against your religion? Explain it to me. Well, she said to me, isn't it putting something, through your rectum? I said, yes, it involves that. But she said, we don't do that. So I went through a list of explanation, and she came to an understanding at the end of the day. And she said, oh, I didn't think it was that way. But again, she said, I don't want anybody to go with me, and I don't want anybody to hear about it. But because I'm feeling sick, and now you have explained it to me, I'll go do it. So it's good that she came to that understanding. But what I'm trying to say here is that there is a language barrier, yes. Especially when it comes to the medical terms and the language around the hospital and stuff like that. They won't understand it that easy. So language barrier exists. Yeah. Is there a way that we can help? Yes, if they ask. But the other side of it too is that asking by itself is considered not acceptable. See, if they ask, they think they are regarded as somebody that doesn't know anything. So instead, they would just, boast as if they know it. This is one area too that our community needs to talk about. It's okay to say, like, I need an interpreter. Or it's okay to take, young children that are born here and grew up here, if you take them with you, they'll interpret, they'll help. Because that's what I tell my wife, this is not sacred. I tell her, either take me with you when you see your doctor, or take a female person that you feel comfortable with, but somebody that can explain it to you what the doctor says, or what the, when your results of the test come back, take someone with you so that you get the clear understanding of what's going on with your health.